Bismillah, the Rahman, the Rahim, with Allah's name, the merciful benefit giver, the merciful redeemer. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. I testify as an eyewitness that there is no thing, no one, no person, no people, etc., to be worshipped. Wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasulullah. And I testify as an eyewitness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, prayers and peace be upon him, the mortal human being who lived over 1,450 some years ago. He is one of the messengers of the Almighty Lord God Creator, and he is the seal of all the prophets. This is part two. We're speaking concerning the scripture words which say they distorted the alphabets and the words. Excuse me. They distorted the alphabets and the words. And as I pointed out in the previous broadcast, that statement that there was a change in the word system is written in both the Holy Bible and the Sacred Quran. There is the Eastern word, which means to change alphabets, change the alphabets. You change the alphabets, you change the words. You change the alphabets and the words, you change the spirit of the message. They changed, they distorted the alphabets and the words. They changed, they distorted the spirit of the religious message. Why? Why would any group of people do that? For power. Power, the ability to control or otherwise influence other people. Power, control of the natural resources of the world. Don't we see that in today's society? That power, both examples, is in the hands of a very, I'll say, very select, a very elite few. That's the way they refer to themselves, as the elite. The elect, not you and I, the common people. Worldwide, it is the same small but very powerful group of people who have control of nations. Let Let's see, let's look further into the scriptures and get the knowledge, the science that the scriptures tell us about this situation. And remember, let me point out once again, as I have did so many times before, that is the purpose of the scriptures. The primary purpose of the scriptures is that you and I, the people, the common people, have the knowledge, have the understanding of how this world operates, so that we can be upstanding, knowledgeable people in this world and have access, honorable access, to uplift ourselves. Isn't that what scripture is all about? True scripture? Yes, indeed. Again, I will read the original words and then come back and give the English interpretation of the words. Ach radu wa badal nahum jannatayim. They turned away. They turned away from what? They turned away from the original truth. They turned away from the original message that was sent to them in their holy books. Yes. A segment of the society, that so-called elect few, who wanted to keep power and control in their hands, they turned away from the truth of the scriptures. Wa badal nahum janat dahim. And we changed their two gardens. We changed their two gardens. Why? Because they had turned away from the truth. They had turned away from that which is right and correct for all people. And as a result, the divine Lord God Creator changed their situation. They were in a situation as two gardens. Remember what scripture teaches us about everyday life, real life. What are the two gardens that we human beings experience in our daily lives? The garden of material success. The garden of spiritual success. Yes, the former societies, they had success, just as the nations of the world today. They have experienced some very powerful material success, very powerful spiritual success. But as we see by worldly events of this day and time, those two gardens, those two situations have been changed. My nation, the United States of America, the most powerful nation on earth, is rocking back and forth like a sinking ship now. Why? Because she got away from the original truth. And now it has come back to punish her. We change the two gardens. The water. Ukulele, Tamten, Waatlin, Washaim, Minsidre. Oh, they had success for a while, for a very long while. But the days of bitterness, the days of punishment are now upon them, upon the world. Ukul, they eat, they consume something. Bitterness. They consume bitterness. And tamarisk. Some of you, well, just like me, I had to research and study and find, what is a tamarisk? In my use of Abdullah Ali of the Quran, Atalla is translated into English as tamarisk. And yes, in other scriptures, you will find that word tamarisk. Tamarisk. Plants that are bitter. Plants that you don't want to consume. You want to stay away from. When you taste it, it can choke you up, take your breath away, take your body functions away, and may even be lethal, poison. So the two gardens, their material success, their spiritual success has now been changed after a very long while. They are now facing bitterness, choking up situation, a withering, dying type situation. Washaim, and a thing, Minsidrin, a thing of acacia. I have that word there, acacia, highlighted. That should be very important to religious people. Th- think, where have you seen that word before in scripture? Acacia. Acacia is a type of tree. Trees produce wood. So the scriptures are saying here that the societies produced or developed something like akin to a tree. A tree body of knowledge. Doesn't the scriptures, the Holy Bible, and the sacred Quran, don't they both teach us? That a tree is akin to a body of knowledge. So let's look deeper into this acacia tree. Laqad ra'ahu nazlatan ukra. Indeed, he saw him. Nazlatan ukra. On a second descent. Ladies and gentlemen, sisters and brothers, human beings, human society, all we are living in a very pressing time, but also it is a very divine time. The will of the Almighty Lord God Creator is being did. Second descent. Haven't you been waiting? Haven't we? The good thinking, hopeful people, right minded people. Haven't we been looking for a second descent? The Christians call it the second coming of the Jesus Christ. The sacred Quran speaks of it in chapter 23, verses 12 through 14, as the development of the second creation. Both are talking about the second. The second Adam, the second development of the human society. Yes, this world is being changed. In the Sidratin il Muntaha. The location of the lotus tree, Sidra. Remember that word? That is the location of the lotus tree, the acacia tree, the tree, that body of knowledge which marks a point beyond which no one should pass. Okay, now, in real everyday life, knowledge and science, what is that telling us about the world's events in this day and time. That body of people, wicked people, who changed the scriptures long, long ago and passed it down through their selected people, their selected generations. They passed the knowledge down from generation to generation to those people whom they wanted from their families to stay in control of the mass of society. One of the techniques that they used, they came up with a doctrine. They mixed true scripture with their own false doctrines. They came up with a teaching which they designed to keep the mass of the people, the mass of the world's people, dependent upon them, looking to them as the gods of this world. They even went so far as writing a doctrine that established one particular race of people as divine. Yes, those wicked manipulators, they gave that idea to the leaders of America. When America was first forming, people coming from Europe, people whom the Holy Bible describes as Gentiles, they were given a scripture, 1619, King James Authorized Version, King James Authorized Version. The beginning, the Genesis of a new world order, the Western Hemisphere, a world order that was built upon the foundation of skin color, race superiority. Study your scriptures, study your history. Right now in the United States of America, in the halls of government in Washington, D.C., there is a letter from one of the early presidents, Thomas Jefferson. In that letter, President Jefferson is saying, if there is such a thing as a God in heaven, then one day we will surely be judged. We will have to pay for what we have did. What was he talking about? What was so 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 pressing upon his mind that his conscience was eating away at him. It was the adoption of a doctrine, a policy, a strategy for control of the public. They turned away from simply believing in, trusting in, and abiding in the words of the Lord. Now, so many these centuries later, the divine plan has called for their judgment. The judgment of those leaders amongst the American society who accepted that strategy, powerful people amongst business, religion, education, and politics. Also, powerful people amongst the nations of the world accepted that strategy and used it in their nations also to control their people. The Almighty Lord God Creator in this day and time is freeing the slave. The slave society worldwide, in America and worldwide. The Lord God Creator has opened up the knowledge. It's been right here in the books all this time. But it's the Lord's clock. It's the Lord's timepiece, which decides when we should know. It is no accident that we hear people like myself speaking this truth nowadays. It is a divine result. It is part of the divine plan. The world is being freed. Yes, there are some, those wicked influences, they are fighting very, very hard to hold on to their control. But the scriptures have already said they will fail. And a new world, back to the original foundation that we were all created upon, shall be established, is being established in this day and time. Have no doubt, do not fear, do not grieve, people. The righteous people, this is your day and time. This is the day of the Lord. This is the day of religion. This is the judgment day. For here, in this life, yes, we have another final judgment. But this is the judgment in this life. Don't we deserve that? After all we've been through, the generations and generations, don't we deserve some peace, some success in this world? Not only in the world after, the hereafter, we deserve some success in this world. And the Lord is now giving it to us. Thank you for your time. Please research and study the materials I have shared with you. In the comments section, I will also post notes, references, where you can go and double check the things that I have shown you and the things that I have shared with you. Please leave your comments. Please like this video. Please go to my YouTube channel and subscribe. Thank you all. Assalamu alaikum. The peace be upon you. Ramadan Mubarak.